making it extremely difficult to, you know, find people, you know, cast your spells correctly. It's just such an annoying hero to play against right now.
The thing that I find absurd is that nighttime duration, crippling fear level 1, 5 seconds. That is a very long duration silence. And the first night, you get a silence on somebody, I mean, they're more than likely either going to not contribute into the team fight or just dead in general. So with a hero that, you know, with the Night Stalker, with the Ancient Apparition, with the Ogre Magi, they have some ganky heroes. And Ember Spirit, well, he falls, you know, pretty quickly when it comes to silences. You've got to be careful, I'd say.
Yeah, silences are definitely the bane of Ember's existence. A very squishy hero, especially in the early game. And honestly, he tends to not build too many defensive items. You know, sometimes we'll see a Lincoln's, maybe even a Manta, but his early item progression probably not going to be so defensive, so this silence is going to be pretty crucial. Although I expect in this game, with playing against the Night Stalker, that he will actually opt for a Manta first, possibly.
Yeah, that's the build that we've seen occasionally, and with mixed results, I'd say. Manta style is certainly not a bad item, but you like other items on the hero a little
bit
more.
Battle Fury, Daedalus, stuff like that.
Let me just get all that damage that I possibly can get, and, well, maybe not this game. Well, Centaur Warrunner picked up for Secret. Virtus Pro grabbed the Jakiro. On the other side, for the bans, it was a Marana, and of course the puppy-targeted Dazzle ban as well, and you can even say the puppy-targeted Marana ban too, so.
This Luna ban is pretty interesting to me. It's not a hero that we've actually seen too much.
Sort of synergize with Night Stalker for like the 5 seconds that Eclipse is up, I guess.
I mean, I suppose so. At level 16, I guess Eclipse lasts like 5 or 6 seconds
or
something.
It's those little synergies, man. I wonder what the Luna Night Stalker win rate is. We talked about the Bane Enigma in the first game.
Yeah, well, I mean, when those heroes were in their prime, they were actually both quite strong, so.
Oh, absolutely. No doubt about it. Luna
probably wouldn't be too surprising to have quite a high win rate.
Dude, I'm surprised that Luna's fallen so out of favor. Like, I've seen her a couple of times in 6.82. I've yet to see her in 6.83.
The hero just has some functional issues. Like, if you start losing your lane, it's very easy to just constantly get ran at and just feed.
Functional issues is a really nice way of putting, like, you've got some major problems.
Yeah. It's just like... the hero is too susceptible. I think you can snowball with the hero and really like take over the game, get all the outer towers, all 6 towers, sort of like what LGD Int used to do, how they used to run Luna, but running it in the standard carry fashion is just not the way you want to play the hero. And with every game going to the late game, she's a really strong 6 slot carry, but not too good with 2 or 3 items, so... she definitely might have her place, but I don't think it's in this meta right now.
No. Maybe someday Ice Frog will bless her with some gracious nerfs, but until that day comes, she was in the meta for a long period of time. It's not necessarily a bad thing that she's out of the meta. We see less and less of, you know, heroes like Batrider as well, so we're getting away from the old meta and we're getting into new hero territory, which isn't quite nice. And for now, we see heroes like Disruptor and Jakiro get picked up for both of these squads, and I'm certainly not going to complain about that. Team Secret, they seem to be on the forefront of trying out new heroes, trying out new strategies. Them and Evil Geniuses, although Evil Geniuses have had a bit of a downturn recently. I hope Artur's in the chat. He was flaming me earlier, and I'm going to flame him right back, so...
Do you think this is going to be a support Elder Titan, or are we going to see that offlane Elder Titan with the safe lane Centaur this game? Or will we see an offlane Centaur and then a support Elder Titan? Because I know that it's sort of 2 no-tail heroes, right? Puppy plays Disruptor, but...
yeah, that's true. That is a good point. I think Puppy has a big enough hero pool that they can get away with the dual support. I don't know if Misery plays a lot of Centaur. I imagine he does. I think he played it yesterday. I'm not 100% sure on that. I'm more inclined to believe that they go for Disruptor Elder Titan support, but Misery Elder Titan last game was absurd, so it could go either way, honestly. Man, that's a cop-out answer, but that's what I'm thinking.
I think they're going to pick a... maybe it depends on what VP pick, actually. It allows them a lot of flexibility that they can have multiple options in how they lane this and how they, you know, set their heroes up, so... That's actually going to be a Death Prophet. I think Virtus Pro are one of the better teams at actually using the Death Prophet in the scene.
And they went to Costco for this fifth pick, Death Prophet. Yes, I will buy that on sale, please. I would very much like that Death Prophet pick. They get it done.
I mean, it is a hero that pretty much never gets banned anymore. And it's going to do quite well in the mid lane if it is up against that Ember Spirit. Yep, it's going to be a support Venge.
There it is. Support Venge coming out. Disruptor for No Tail. Misery offlane Elder Titan. Why fix thing that isn't broke? And Misery's Elder Titan that last game was phenomenal, I'd say. So.
Yeah, it was quite good and impressive. So it looks like we are going to see this Death Prophet versus Ember Spirit in the mid lane. I think Death Prophet definitely has a significant advantage early in the laning phase with the constant spam. I mean, you can just constantly right-click Ember. She's a high base damage, good animation, going to be able to get pretty much all the CS she wants and make Ember struggle just a little bit. Nope. Unless it's going to be it's not going to be a safe lane Ember. There's no way Centaur's mid. It's going to be safe lane Centaur.
I think that was the last time they ran it, though. It was a safe lane Ember. But I don't think that's going to be... I think you're right. Yeah. They have... I'm just trying to find it before in that regard, so...
It actually looks like VP are actually... They have a safe lane Nightstalker, so that's kind of interesting.
Try BZZ's heading top currently. Aggro try against what do they have? I think this is good. I think against a Disruptor, I'm not sure if he's the best defensive tri lane support against an aggro try.
I wouldn't like you don't want to aggro tri lane with a hero that is so experience dependent. Yeah, it's definitely
maybe Duel Links.
Is this an aggro tri lane? Well, it might be. I'm just
maybe
a little
just
concerned because
the rune.
Nightstalker is such a level-dependent hero, and when you have an aggressive tri-lane, if the lane doesn't go well for you, you're going to be extremely underleveled, and Nightstalker's not a hero that comes back into the game once he gets underleveled.
The one thing that I also am not a big fan of is the fact that Nightstalker before the first night is fodder. He doesn't provide much. Void's damage is okay. But obviously the duration is what you're looking for in terms of the slow to chase down heroes and Hunter in the Night, obviously giving you that extra bit of a boost in terms of combat ability. However, Ogre Magi and Jotam on the Ancient Apparition, especially like Chilling Touch, they can maybe buff up the heroes.
I mean, they definitely have a lot of kill potential, but I'm just saying if they don't find the kills in the site and, you know, if Secrets start getting these pulls off, it could just end up slowly being a disaster for them because they won't get the levels necessary onto this Nightstalker. That's generally why we see him mid. He's not like an exceptional laner. He just needs the levels.
Yeah. But what I do like is the fact that they know that Sidoy, who had a really rough time in the offlane last time, they give him a solo lane now up against a solo Elder Titan.
Yeah, he should do quite well in this lane.
And no more feeding. Sidoy has had it. He's annoyed. This is, I think, the third game in a row he's played this hero, I believe. Correct me if I'm wrong. We'll see if he comes out on top again. So game number two getting underway. For Virtus Pro, you've got Yol playing your Ogre Magi in this top lane with the aggro trailing. Jotam playing the Ancient Apparition. BZZ on the Nightstalker. We will have in the mid lane currently G or God playing the Death Prophet. Down bottom, it is Sidoy playing your Jakiro, and that'll round out your Virtus Pro CIS lineup.
Yep. And on the Dire side, for Secret, and we're going to have Kuroki playing the Centaur War Runner. It's going to be Puppy on the Vengeful Spirit and Big Daddy No Tail once again on this Disruptor. With, I must say, one of the ugliest looking mounts I've ever seen.
Oh, you don't like that?
No,
oh,
I
man.
Don't. I think all the mounts for Disruptor are ugly.
No, that's just like your opinion, man.
Yeah, I said I think.
Chilling Touch, are they going to make a go? Oh, they thought about it. And they just realized they didn't have range because Yol's Fire Blast level 1. That's the problem, man. You need Ignite level 1 if you're going to try to fight this.
S4 in the mid lane on this Ember Spirit.
Is BZZ dead? He is maybe in trouble. Magic Missile. Again, I cut you off at first blood, but BZZ is going to fall, and it's going to be Puppy getting the first blood there as BZZ stayed a bit too long, and that's not good.
Yeah, that just can't happen, actually, in that lane. Like, I mean, like I was talking about... And in the bottom lane, we're going to have Sidoya on the Jakiro in this 1v1 matchup up against Misery on the Elder Titan.
Misery is low, to say the very least.
Yeah, he's definitely struggling in this lane.
Picks up a double damage. That would be nice any other time if he had, like, a salve, but he doesn't have one, so... I guess for Secret, you know, this is going well for them. However, you do look at G, he is getting a lot of CS. Nightstalker is still doing well despite getting killed early on, and bottom lane is going as expected, I guess, for Virtus Pro Sadoi.
I mean, I suppose they are having the highest farmers on the CSing charts, so they are keeping down this center, which is pretty important. It actually looks like Puppy's getting the majority of the last hits in this lane. And once it hits Knight at 4 minutes, this is going to be a very scary aggro trailing. But like I said, they are losing out on experience onto BZZ.
And BZZ will not be at super ganky potential like you would see
Mystery
on the
might be in trouble.
The Liquid Fire, will it take him down?
Yeah, he's dead.
And he's dead. Lethal damage coming in from the Liquid Fire gets the kill, and Sadoi able to pick up one, and that just dominates that lane for him. He was already winning in CS, and now he gets a kill on top of it. He'll be able to CS under his tower. No experience going the way. Meanwhile, top lane, Kinetic Field, Magic Missile onto BZZ. Fire Blast going in. Ignite, no tail. He's not going to get cold feet. It doesn't matter. He's dead anyways. Double stomp from Kuroki coming through. Body blocks. Puppy now in trouble. Puppy's going to go down. Double kill for Yol, and now the levels are going to start to come. Level 3 for BZZ. TP coming in now from yet another hero. It's a re-rotation from Big Daddy No Tail. Kuroki's too tanky for them to take down. They might get Jotam on the back end. Kinetic Field, and Yol is going to leave him to die. And then he definitely should. Double Edge is going to come out, and Kuroki does get one kill. 2-for-1 exchange. Virtus Pro will take that all day, every day, as they get a bit of gold going the way of Yol and a couple of levels as well.
Pretty nice from VP. So they're actually winning all three of these lanes right now. So you can't ask for anything more than that. I was a little concerned that they weren't going to get quite enough levels on this Night Circuit. He is only level 3, but it is currently working out quite nicely for them.
And the lanes are really just, in terms of CS, like you talked about, it's not going Secret's way.
So he actually goes for Phase Boots.
Which hero?
Sadoi on the Jakiro. Usually we see Tranquils, but you know, when you're in a 1v1 like this, he can actually just Liquid Fire and then Dual Breath him and right-click him down with face.
Does this change your build? Strong. Does this change the Yule's build? Does he go for another item in this situation, or does he stay the course?
No. I think you still go Yule's. Yule's is just the best item on Jakiro by far. It sets up all of your other spells and gives you a lot of additional kill potential.
Keeps you alive too. But no. Guys, if you are playing in, say, around 3k matchmaking, maybe even lower than that, just build Yule Scepter on a couple of these really good heroes, Puck and Jakiro specifically. You'll win the game, I promise.
Well, maybe not Puck, because if you're 3k, you might forget to use it on yourself.
Damn, dude. We're not here to flame the players. We're here
just
to cast Dota.
It does look like
you're just a bit salty because of your last night's endeavors in matchmaking. Sadoi is going to get jumped on. Ice Path. Playing guard, but good rotation from Yol. Stops the aggression. However, S4 Haste Rune. Are you kidding me? Come on. Remnant comes in just to get out. He will jaunt away. And he's going to make it out. Easy kill for S4 with the Haste Rune because, you know, he just gets those runes. And Misery is hammering home on Yol. Stick up. Fire Blast. The right time, and Misery can't get the kill. And he has to back away.
Now, that was the only rune that actually gets him a kill there. Yol is...
God.
Okay, he's barely going to survive that Astral Spirit.
Tango saved his freaking life.
A nice play there by S4, though, to buy a TP on the courier after he gets the 4-minute haste rune, and then the second he hits 6, he just TPs to the bottom lane, and they get a nice pickoff onto this Jakiro, who is getting pretty out of control in this safe lane.
I want to ask you, do you know what perfect CS is at 10 minutes? By the way, I'm curious.
It's 82.
82, and currently at 42 for G.
Yeah, G's actually having a phenomenal game in this mid lane in terms of CS. So 42 at 6 minutes is...
Yeah, pretty good.
Quite good.
I don't know if he'll hit 82. I'm pretty sure he's missed a creeper or two, but he's going to get up there.
He's about 7 CS off, I think, perfect right now.
That's pretty damn good. That is a lot of creeps going his way, which will provide him a pretty quick Yule. He already has phase. Bottom lane, TP rotations. Misery trying to deny the tower.
Oh,
he's actually slow. He does get it, though. That staple gun coming in handy. S4 looking for Sadoi, and there's the glimpse back in. Magic Missile, and 4 heroes just for a Jakiro, but that Jakiro is very high value, And Secret have to find these kills because they're certainly not finding the farm.
Yeah, I actually think VP are in a decent spot right now just because of how farm G is getting in this lane. Sure, they've killed the Jakiro twice, but that bottom tower is now gone for Secret, so that's going to give open up the map a little bit. And once G gets level 11, I think they're going to be in a hard place.
And well, he's actually just going right on right S4. The phase boots, the null tally, and the bracer coming into play. G can't secure the kill, but he gets as close as possible to making...
I thought G was going to pop the exorcism there, actually. Because even if he forces the remnant out, he's going to do a tremendous amount of damage to this tower.
Maybe he saw no tail. Not that he's really scared of the disruptor, but...
He can fight like two or three heroes right now.
Does he have max witchcraft? No, 1 point away from it.
Yeah.
Kuroki has done a very good job of making sure he's not getting dove. Level 4 coming out for both VP supports despite being in an aggro tri lane. They are a couple of trees away from killing Kuroki right now. BZZ does not see him. Kuroki's going to walk out. TP rotation. There's the exorcism. Stomp on a Jotun coming in. More TPs coming through from Secret. S4 Flimguard going in, saving his life for the time being, but he gets blown up. He is just dead as hell. They will kill Jotun as well. It's a one-for-one exchange. G is just going to right-click Kuroki down the urn charge. Stomp goes onto a creep. G gets a double kill. Tower is free for the taking. Will he get it? It's the question. As he has a Crypt Storm to clear the wave, not even needed. On the backside, Void on a No-Tail. No-Tail gets Fire Blasted. Right-click down. Puppy comes in. Yul might fall, but BZZ is going to continue on just hammering it home. And triple kill for G as well on the back end. Four dead from Secret.
Triple kill for G.
What a disaster.
G's just going to get out of control. Like, they're not going to be able to deal with him pretty soon. And if we look at the CS from Secret, VP have dominated these lanes thoroughly. Like, kills might be even right now, but this gold advantage is entirely in CS and that one tower in the bottom lane as well.
If they don't get G here, that would be a travesty. G is... They glimpsed back the kinetic field. They had a couple of heroes right-clicking down. Match missile long ball coming in. Puppy gonna still is going to die. The Jakiro dual breath coming in. Macro pyre to cut off the path of aggression, but still, they walk right through it. They go for BZZ. Thunderstrike and a right click will kill him, but they miss. Misery can't get there yet. They might lose another hero because they took too long. The liquid fire will pick up no tail. 3-2 so far. The fight recap doesn't know what's happening. They deny the tier one tower, and this does give some room in the mid lane for S4, who desperately needed it.
Man, he desperately needs farm on this Ember Spirit. Only sitting at 22 CS. He does have 3 kills, so he's had a lot of nice roaming plays, especially that first one with the haste rune.
And now, Flame Guard pushing the wave, but drum done for G, exorcism down, getting closer and closer to that level 11, that level 2 ultimate. Yule Sifter will be completed shortly after he picks up this drum. In fact, already has 700 gold on top of that. And once you have level 11, and you also have your Yule Sceptre, with the amount of farm that Secret has, it's not easy. Although Kuroki's getting closer to Blink Dagger. Pretty good. Pretty good, G.
And I expect to see this mid-tier one falling fairly shortly. As far as actually dead.
And another TP cancel. That was No-Tail. He couldn't fight that alone. They might try to find Jotun bottom.
But that's only a support AA. I mean, I suppose at this point you could take what you can get, but they're going to lose this mid-tower to the exorcism being popped. They might actually even continue after this, liquid fire the mid-tower a couple times.
And I don't know if they have enough. I mean, Blink Stomp's good, but S4 is at least 15 to 20 minutes away from being online, unless something miraculous happens. And he's really the only... way into the late game, whereas Virtus Pro have G, who has his level 2 ult soon. BZZ is getting good farm. Darkness is popped.
Looks like they're actually going to find No-Tail here.
He is going to pop the Static Storm. Void actually takes off a third of his health. Silence goes, earns up. Double Remnant coming in. Blink Stomp. This could be the turnaround they're looking for. Sidoi's going to be the first kill. BZZ is going to be the second kill. And Yul getting chased down. Will they get 3? He does stick up. They have a glimpse? I don't believe so, because of course No-Tail is dead. That's why they don't have one. And 3 dead on the side of Virtus Pro. They lose No-Tail, a worthy trade. Finally getting back on the board. Secret, they're not out of it yet.
Extremely overconfident by VP, especially the path they took without any vision of any of the heroes on Secret either.
Oh my, Kuroki, that Observer Ward just paid for itself. and they get the kill. Kuroki is going to get, he has Stampede if he needs to get out, but he seems to be fine. BCC comes in, Stomp coming through, gets canceled by Misery. Courier bringing something. Meanwhile, Puppy does kill G in the top lane, and they're starting to get kills. TP in from Sidoi. This might turn around. S4, Flame Guard, not enough. Sled Fist keeps him alive, can't kill BZZ. Now after Kuroki, Blink Stomp, and he gets the kill on the Night Stalker. Cheeky play. He'll fall to Yol, but he's accomplished his mission. Misery backing out. Stomp's available. They have Fire Blast. They have Ignite coming through. Sidoi has Ice Path. They have Dual Breath. But they juked him. Misery gets away. And he won't chase underneath the tower as Misery got that movement speed buff coming in for the Astral Spirit. He'll throw it out again. Yul's going to get chased down by it, but no follow-up damage coming in from Secret as everyone's still across the map.
Yeah, it seems like VP are throwing just a little bit. It almost feels like they're playing way too overconfident against the Secret lineup, and giving away kills right now is pretty detrimental, especially with such a large advantage that they had. And all they had to do, I think, was just wait for the Exorcism cooldown and regroup as five, you know, maybe just sit back a little bit, farm their own jungle, get some wards up because they were lacking in the ward department as well, and, you know, just chill for a minute, and then once your cooldowns are up, you can either go for a smoke play or maybe bait someone or even just five-man push, because at that point, I don't think there's anything Secret could do.
Sleight of Fist, Searing Chains, and S4 will secure this kill that I thought was going to go and get out of reach for Secret. Misery's going to get cold-feeded up with the Ice Vortex underneath him. They throw out another one, but there's no follow-up. Not yet, anyway. Yul's too far away. G does have Exorcism. He's ready to go. All the Tier 1 towers have been taken, whereas on the other side of things, Secret have yet to take one of those. And they're still really close in net worth right now. In fact, 2,000 down. So it's not out of the reach. It's not out of reach for Secret by any stretch. And it felt like they were getting trashed, just absolutely trashed in this early game.
Yeah, I mean, there were, and this Blink Dagger from Kuroki has been doing amazingly.
Swap out Puppy, Magic Missile, Long Range, Static Storm onto Yul, but where's the follow-up damage? It might be enough. There's a glimpse back, but where do they have Stomp, Earth Splitter off the mark coming through? No more follow-up as everyone's just staying on the high ground from Secret. They don't want to over-engage. They know that any one bad engagement can give that much more gold back to Virtus Pro.
Well, they still don't have level 6 on Jotun.
That's a byproduct of the aggro tri lane, yep. I think. TP out from S4. He did throw down the Remnant, so he can jump back in. Kuroki is, by the way, building a force staff. He's sitting in the trees currently, unassuming, and everyone rotates bottom for Virtus Pro. And I think they're going to push the tier 2 with Exorcism now.
Yeah, they got the level 11 onto Death Prophet, and now they've finally decided enough is enough. We're going to go group as 5. Push down these tier 2 towers, and they should be able to get this pretty easily, barring some weird team fight, I think.
They're going to instead try to find Yol, but he TP'd out on top of this Observer Ward, so now they know that he's bottom, and if you're Secret, I don't think you fight here.
Yeah, I don't think so either. I think fighting here would be a huge mistake. It does look like they might be interested, though. You know, if Kuroki can get some heroes on the backline, you know, maybe instantly kill the Ancient Apparition or something. And then
look
Stampede
how far away.
Away
he is, though.
Well, he's gonna try to come from behind.
It's gonna take some time. Darkness goes, Fire Blast, S4, does have Flame Guard, so
I mean,
he doesn't take any damage.
They have this really nice placed Observer Ward right here. Although it gives almost no vision right now.
Misery gets silenced up, Magic Missile onto BZZ, Ice Blast connects onto Puppy, he'll fall, Sleight of Fist going, BZZ's low, swap out, Yul should fall, Stomp onto 2, Jotun is gonna fall, looks like Yul as well, they're turning the tide, Secret looking for more. Now Sidoi's getting chased down by Kuroki. Blink Dagger and a couple. Gets canceled, of course, by the Liquid Fire. Doesn't matter. Give him that double edge. Give it to him to the face. Kuroki, Liquid Fire, not going to kill him. 17 HP on the other side. G getting caught out. Static Storm, No Tail coming up big again. Is this a team wipe? Yes. The Thunder Strike comes in and Secret hold their Tier 2 tower. Kuroki, the backline attack. And they get 5 heroes out of the engagement. They deny the tower. That is about 2,000 gold swing, and Kuroki gets most of the gold, and S4 gets a lot of the experience.
Yeah, and that was a really nice defense from Secret. I think VP stayed a little bit too long. The Exorcism, you know, they didn't get out in line with the Exorcism. They kept fighting while Exorcism cooled down, and they ended up paying for it dearly. I mean, we saw Kuroki come from the backlines, blink onto 2 heroes, get a nice 2-hero stomp into double edge instantly kills two of their heroes. And this Nightstalker pick actually has not been too effective from BP. He's actually extremely underfarmed. And only level 9 as well.
You think that is, of course,
it's because they aggroed.
Now, Yule Scepter's gonna go. That actually does avoid a lot of damage for GM because he's so fast he could just run away. But there's the glimpse, the kinetic field, and G is gonna fall. No tail again. MVP glimpses, they get two. Yule's gonna be the third. Puppy, he might fall, but it doesn't matter because they're gonna try to get more off the back end. Slated Fist, S4, Silence up, they get the fourth. Will they get the fifth? Another team wipe. Kuroki, four staff, Stomp is up in one. He's gonna get it off, and now S4 going to work as well with the double damage rune. They get all five of them. S4 with the double kill. They're gonna get the tier 1 tower. Secret are on the warpath, and they've got 2,000 net worth back in their favor. They're starting to lead this game.
Wow. That's another 5-man team fight. They only get the Venge in that fight. Huge plays coming up from No-Tail, and really nice glimpse from him setting up that fight.
Ice Blast. Ooh, No-Tail, look out, buddy. He's gonna get hit. Fire Blast goes in, Stomp going through as well. They run it away. G, oh god. Glimpse coming in, S4. Yule Scepter goes up and he might die as well. Stick, Silence is gonna be going. Cryptstorm right click, not enough yet. They'll try to get him out. They pop the drone charge, G. Cryptstorm misses again. Kuroki, Astral's up. They know where they are. They have Blink Stomp. Stampede in six, Yule's still chasing. Stomp's gonna go, Siri Chains as well. Where's the follow-up coming through? It looks like Secret just want to disengage. Virtus Pro, they've got other ideas. Sadoi comes in, Ice Path with the Yule Scepter. Puppy is going to fall yet again. It looks like Ice Blast off the mark, but the Ignite will take him down. Now jumping in, Kuroki, Blink Stomp. There's the double edge coming through the right click. Astral, Stampede, multicast. What skill from Yule? What RNG coming in? Kuroki, he's going to shatter up. He's done.
He's barely live with 20 HP.
And now the Exorcism. Now it's Virtus Pro's turn to run at Secret. Silence, they're running into the base, past the Tier 3 tower. Centaur buys back, and now Virtus Pro need to leave. Gee, so low in health. Thunderstrike, they have nothing else. They do have Glimpse, I believe, in a couple of seconds. No, Kinetic Field popped up. Gee, Searing Chains, not enough. 25 HP. They turn around. They get the kill on BZZ. S4 still chasing. Remnants are up. He pops one forward. He still has another one. They're chasing after. Big Searing Chains. It will fall to it with the right click. And obviously the Sleight of Fist coming in. Big buyback from Kuroki. Prevents any further dives. What the hell happened in that fight? Let's check out the fight recap and he'll tell us how it went. Well, Pretty good for Virtus Pro.
Yeah, it was actually quite good for Virtus Pro. They get three, a buyback is forced, and they only lose two in the end, but the Exorcism is on cooldown now, so. Well, that AA ult actually just completely misses.
Yeah, but Kuroki still has the trail on him, so he does have to be a bit careful. S4 are the same.
They can't do this, actually.
They need everybody there. Medallion or not, this is too
difficult. Oh, they have a regen rune.
Are they really?
Yeah, maybe they can. Yeah,
S4 in fact does have one, but here comes BZZ. It is nighttime. It is just nighttime as well. Stampede, swap back out. Remnants kind of miss. Doesn't matter. Searing Chain's doing all the work that they need him to do, but still alive. Thunderstrike, now the glimpse out. They finally get the kill. A lot of effort expended. They had to work out for that one. Misery, multicasted, silenced up. Wave of Terror, he's actually left out to dry. Can they save him? Team not looking to re-engage. Secret's already
Misery's
gone.
Dead. So they do stop the Rosh attempt, they trade an offlaner for, I guess this is a carry Nightstalker, but not really having such an impact. He's actually 3, 9, and 10. So he's dead 9 times.
G is the highest priority target at this point. We can call him the carry, I think.
Yeah.
30 to 20. Secret have gone from an abysmal early game. Yeah, to this kill-oriented game. And I don't know if it's really benefiting S4. They just drum and perseverance.
They've just had more members in these early game engagements. And, you know, VP with a couple of mistakes just allowed Secret completely back into this game.
Well, actually, S4's Battle Fury time, considering what phase drum, is not going to be that bad.
Yeah, it's probably going to be about a 23-24 minute Battle Fury. It's quite good, actually, with the completed drums.
Do you still think Manta style for this hero at some point in time?
Yeah, I think so. Just because they have the silence from Krob, so. And as well as the Nightstalker, I think it's quite good. BP are gonna get this rush in with the Exorcism.
Sleight of Fist, big fight, big static storm coming in. Stomp from Kuroki, double edge onto two. They will take two down, but that's the Aegis going through. Swap out onto one Puppy. He'll be the target now. Crypt Swarm glimps back onto somebody. I'm not sure. Magic Missile. Puppy's going to solo kill Jotam. Big kill for him. A support for two. Now, Thunderstrike, no glimpse available for 7 seconds now. Remnant back in. S4 looking for Yul, misses the Searing Chains, but the stomp is there from Kuroki to follow up with his teammate Macropyre. Now the stomp comes in from the side of the Elder Titan. They lose Kuroki, but they've got four heroes. The only hero alive is G. He's going to phase away. He's got Remnant. He's got, obviously, the Searing Chains, but will not continue to chase. The Astral goes through. They're not going to go any further than that. And Roche, unfortunately, was taken, so Secret can't transition this into anything. But again, another good fight going their way.
Yeah, they really need this BKB onto G, and he finally picks it up. These fights are going to be a lot different now. I think the complexion with the BKB onto G is going to make these fights very, very different. He's just getting blown up in the Static Storm, and then he gets hoof stomped, double-edged, and it's so much burst damage that he just can't handle it right now. But now that he has this BKB, this first BKB usage with the level 16 ultimate, which he now has, is going to be pretty important if VP are going to have a chance to come back into this game.
Yul's BKB, we've talked often about how the item choice is BKB now, but sorry, go ahead.
Honestly, VP aren't too far behind if we go ahead and take a look at gold. They're only about 3,000 gold behind. About, 6,000 experience. That's not too big of a deal because you win one team fight and you're pretty much even in experience. And I think the majority of that is just Jotam being only level 8 on this support AA.
I think the major difference between this game with the Nightstalker and the last game is BZZ in the aggro trialing didn't get enough done, wasn't able to get the kills, and he's sitting only at a Vanguard urn in comparison to, I think, a Maelstrom and maybe more in the last game for S4.
Yeah, they missed the stomp on Jotam,
but that's true. No Midas coming out for BZZ. Jotam gets glimpsed back, free kill. They're going to chase after Puppy, though. Yul Scepter, Stampede, they're going to try to get him away, but he's silenced up, forced out of the ice path, not going to matter. They blow the Exorcism, Sleight of Fist, Searing Chains. Catches him in place. S4 and Misery back up to the high ground. Tier 2 tower gonna get assaulted. Glimpse coming back in. Is that on to G? He pops the BKB. He could have done it beforehand. Now the Earth Splitter going through. They don't have the right hook to deal with G right now. They have to wait until this BKB is done. So they're just gonna wait it out. Let the Tier 2 tower go. They will glyph it, however. G's BKB now on cooldown. Duration's done. Kinetic Field onto Sadoi again. Static Storm onto 2. Sadoi should fall here. Looks like he will. No follow-up. TP home from G. He'll make it out. Glimpse coming back in. I'm not sure. Yeah, it was actually onto Yul. It's tough keeping track of these, man. And they get the kill.
No. And they... Sure, they get the Tier 2 tower there, but I don't think they got enough out of that first BKB usage on the Death Prophet. They forced him to BKB, and then they just sort of ran away. And there's not too much VP can do at this point when they just run away. They really need to catch someone in this Yules from Jakiro, and then... you know, lock him down and kill him, but it has to be one of these high priority targets, you know, maybe the Ember Spirit or the Centaur.
Can't be Puppy anymore.
No.
Although, they've done a good job of killing Puppy when he's out, but, I mean, Puppy's job is to die, a martyr, essentially. If he's swapped, then he's fine with it for the most part. You'd like to Wave of Terror consistently over the fight, but dying for the team, he'll take one every time. S4 now with the Battle Fury. Next item, maybe the Mantis style, might see a crit first. And other than that, those are the two items I can think of at this point in time for S4.
I think it's going to be a Mantis style. And then we'll see a Daedalus. If the game goes that far, at least. Or long.
I got a feeling it will, my friend.
Yeah, I think this game's going to go late.
Still a lot of tier 2s left on the map. Actually, just the one in the mid for Secret, but...
it's so hard. I mean, even if they can get this mid tower, it's so hard to go high ground against the heroes that Secret have.
Puppy is trying to go in.
He's in a lot of trouble.
Well, he swapped BZZ, and actually, they're going to kill the Night Stalker, and they might get more. S4, Remnant to the high ground. Does get Ice Path, Macropyre, but Flimguard helping out a bit. Dual Breath, Remnant comes back in. Yul gets stomped up coming in. Sadoi still getting chased down, but Yul is going to be the sacrificial lamb. G on the backside, Exorcism. He has BKB as well. Big Ice Path coming through. They might get three kills here. Secret have lost three already. Misery is going to be the fourth to fall as well. Jotam juking and jiving, but... alliteration aside, they do get those four kills.
And
maybe the fifth.
Kuroki.
Kuroki has blinked away. He is in the trees, TPing out. Ice Path too late. Too quick on the trigger from
that
Kuroki
was
to TP
really
out.
Really nice fight, though, coming out from VP. I think it was a bit ambitious for Puppy to swap there. His teammates were not really in the best position to aid in that kill, and it ends up costing him his life, and then the rest of Secret, you know, come to help, but VP do an excellent job rotating all of their heroes there to make it a 5 versus 4, and end up with a... Who did they lose there? They lost the Ogre... Was it just the Ogre, actually? So they ended up only losing 1 for 3.
Ogre and Nightstalker.
Okay, so it's a 2 for 4, sorry. Because Puppy died as well.
Most deaths ever for Nightstalker was 12 by Smash versus Snaw. That, really, that is... That seems low.
He's approaching the 12... Well, I mean... It's a core hero. Usually core heroes don't die that much. It's usually the supports that end up becoming feeders.
Well, can he avoid it? BZZ, buddy. You've been playing well so far this series. This is not your game. And G's been doing work.
He definitely needs this BKB. Just to mitigate a lot of the damage that comes up from Secret.
Does he have anything else? He's sitting on this Ogre Cloak for a while.
Vanguard Urn
has not been treating him well.
Misery's actually getting insanely farmed on this Elder Titan. Has a Force Staff and an Ultimate Orb? That's pretty crazy. And
you
with
say
the Midas?
Surprised after the second game where he was also outstandingly farmed.
I guess he had a Dagon 5. Like, if we look at net worth, is he highest?
Misery?
No, he's third on his team. I meant on his team.
He's close
but he's
to...
only 3,000 behind his highest, which is Kuroki.
The BKB Force Blink is doing some work, and obviously
and
the 2,000 gold
on
the bench.
That is actually because Kuroki has 17 kills. Wow.
Didn't see that one. All right, well.
I didn't actually realize he had this many kills. Because I looked at the CS, and I was like, well, Misery must be quite high on the net worth, especially with the Midas, but Kuroki actually just has 17 kills.
You talked about the Blink Dagger doing work. You were not wrong. Is Puppy dead again?
Yeah, he's dead.
All signs point to yes. Goodbye. It's the worst way to die. Cryptstorm straight to your face. Straight to the dome. G is now unstoppable. Picking up his heart. It is flying out to him. This game's a lot closer than I think we've made it out to be.
Yeah.
As now G, that he has the heart. He has the Yules with Exorcism level 3. This is a tough fight for Secret to take, especially 4 versus 5. This tower should probably fall, and I don't think they need Exorcism to kill this one.
Yeah, they aren't going to use it for this tower.
Oh, Kuroki whiffs the Blink Stomp. The other stomp comes in from the Astral. That does hit.
That's
Ice Path.
Play.
No Tail TP's in very aggressively.
I mean, had he got Yules right there, he would have just fallen and been forced to buy back. Does he have buyback? Yeah, he does. Actually, he has a BKB, so never mind.
This is
but he
would have
been forced to pop the BKB.
All the three cores on the side of Secret do have buyback. Everyone else in the game, nope.
Yeah, it looks like VP don't really want to take this fight anymore.
Well, Roche is up soon, so regardless, they're going to maybe take a fight soon. Whether it's at Roche, whether it's at a tier 2 tower. Is there Dire Vision around here? I don't think so. Oh. Yule Scepter on a Kuroki. Darkness pop, there's going to be the Void. Force out, nicely done there from himself.
Yeah, the kinetic field as well, breaking up that fight. Roshan is up, and VP do kill it extremely fast.
Literally no vision coming out from Secret. They have nothing on the map except for in their lane and in their jungle, so...
Yeah. VP have no interest in doing Roshan against the heroes from Secret, though. Like, an Ember plus Elder Titan is not a hero that
no,
you want to be
you.
Sitting in Rosh against.
No, sir, I will not have an Astral Spirit in my face. Just kidding. Let's get him, guys. Exorcism goes.
It's because they see heroes top.
It's immediate TP reactions. Well, at least for Secret. And for Puppy. It doesn't matter. Exorcism was popped. This hero dies too fast. Or rather, Roshan dies too fast. And that's an Aegis for G now. So, Virtus Pro. They're looking like they might take this third game now. It's been back and forth. You can't... I don't want to say any one team has the advantage here, but with G as farmed as he is, S4 is going to have to step his game up.
Mm-hmm. I mean, I think you still favor Secret in going into the late game, I think, because they have extremely difficult high ground defense to break with the Elder Titan as well as the Ember Spirits. But, I mean, if Ember doesn't get farmed enough...
Oh, Kuroki misses really nice his stomp. Stuff. The stampede goes. The magic missile Yule Scepter keeping him up and alive. Kinetic field, ice blast flying through, misses completely. Axe is now done for Yule, by the way. S4 getting chased down.
Oh, silence it's daytime.
Up. Daytime comes through. Darkness, I believe, is done. Glimpse back onto G. They don't want to chase further. Maybe they do. Swap. No! Puppy! They miscommunicate in BZZ. Now the kinetic field. He's the target, but where is the rest of the damage coming through? Kuroki, now the right click. The Wave of Terror. Armor reduction is going. They're in charge. BKB for Kuroki. He really wants to fight this. They still have the Aegis. Exorcism down for 63 seconds. Yule's gonna be the first to die. The first fatality. S4, he's dead as hell. Does have a buyback. I don't think he has a remnant. Still, big kinetic field from No-Tail. Sleight of Fist. There's the Aegis gone. They get BZZ as well. In fact, they get all five. The only hero alive is G. He has to pop the BKB. He's gotta sprint away. Misery, four staff forward. Kuroki, he's got stop in a couple of seconds. Big silence, though. S4, searing chains. Will he get it? He perfectly times the BKB. Just came down. Stop comes in. G's gonna die twice. He does have buyback. His exorcism is up in 29 seconds. What can they get off the back end of this? A tier 2 tower thus far. Anything further, we'll see. The only person with buyback from Virtus Pro is going to be your Death Prophet, and that may be enough. We'll see. Secret goes to the high ground.
That's a very strange decision for VP to engage that fight. They had the BKB on Nightstalker. It just wasn't on his hero yet. It flew out in the courier mid-fight when Nightstalker only had about 400 HP left, and at the same time they had no exorcism available. Sure, you have the Aegis, but DP's damage is just completely tied into his ultimate, or her ultimate, and you know, VP, they just did not have the damage potential in that fight to be taking such a fight.
And that was with a couple of miscues from Secret as well, yeah. At least one.
And against an Aegis, and they still win.
The one issue, though, for Secret is that they get only a tier 3 tower. They don't force out the buyback coming from the Death Prophet. Exorcism is now up again. So all of these things, plus the Negative Scepter for Yule. And while Secret win a fight 5 to, say, 2, I think. I didn't check out the recap. It's still an okay position for Virtus Pro. Not ideal, but okay.
Yeah, I mean, sure, in terms of net worth, it's only 5,000, but...
Sadoi.
It's Misery. Yeah, Misery is, I think, just dead here.
Silence. Macrofire. Goodbye. Not a bad pickup. Third.
It is worth noting, S4 does not have buyback right now. So if they can find a pickup on S4, maybe that is their opportunity to get something done right now. What is Kuroki? Looks like he's going towards a heart. So he's going to get extremely tanky, as well as increasing that return damage.
Alright, Kuroki goes in. Double edge, creep wave. Let's just push this out a bit. Just stomp and get some farm casually. Brad's CPing out. Brad doesn't want to be a part of any ganks. However, Virtus Pro, they weren't going for Brad. They were going for the mid-tier 1 tower. Exorcism's available. Do they get greedy and hold it, or do they just pop it for the tier 2? Glyph's available. They're not using it yet. They probably... Well, there it goes. And Exorcism's still ready to go. And look at the smoke, the wraparound. BZZ. BKB finally done. I don't know if he had it in that last fight, but regardless, the split push is real. As look at S4. Does he have a TP? He absolutely does. Meanwhile, Kuroki's going to jump in, but there's the BKB from G. Exorcism. Yule Scepter up on No-Tail. Swap out from Puppy. And they just blow him up. The multicast is too much. And now they're overrunning the base, the tier 3 tower. Glimpse back onto G. No BKB. Static Storm. Can they take him down? Earth Splitter off the mark. Sleight of Fist goes. BKB for Kuroki. They take him down. He is dead. No usage of that exorcism. Has buyback. Sadoi is very low. Multicast coming through. They take down 3. They're pushing into the base. They TP home at least 1. But Yol's going to fall. The only one to live is BZZ. He's at the top lane. He's trying to push this out. And again, G dives too far. Uses the BKB too early. And Secret hold, they patiently wait, and they take him down with a well-timed glimpse, again from No-Tail.
Yeah. I'm not sure that he used the BKB too early. I mean, he did dodge the stun from the center of the initial one, but, you know, at the same time, after that BKB's cooldown, he also used the Yules offensively, so once the BKB ran out, he was in a terrible position. He just got glimpsed back into a static storm, kinetic field, and then it was an easy follow-up from Kuroki on the center to just double-edge stun him, and then the rest was history.
Ice blast, Kuroki. Well, he's fine. Top lane. S4 going for BZZ. Silence goes in. No Mantis Style. He bought the crystals, by the way. We talked about Mantis Style, but not going to be his choice. That is a long duration silence, by the way. Sleight of Fist, Searing Chase, Son of BZZ, Astral Stomp, Aura should be there, but they missed the stomp. But they will get Kuroki to come in and right click him down, and the double with the Sleight of Fist. Three heroes dead, and they will take this melee rack's top lane. Multicast, Kuroki's too damn tanky. It's a tanky bad boy, the Sentinel Roadrunner coming in. BZZ bought back, BKB, Sleight of Fist, Searing Chains, and Kuroki TP's out like it ain't no thing. Misery going to work, but he's going to get killed as well. Misery for a couple of heroes and a melee Rax. Secret chipping away bit by bit, and Virtus Pro's defenses are starting to crumble.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so they do end up losing the top Rax. I still think there's a little bit of fight left in VP. You know, if they can just get that perfect fight with the Exorcism, get one of these key priority targets into an ice bath, then maybe there's still a chance for them to blow some of these heroes up, especially S4, who does not have buyback. He's getting chased down by BZZ.
Yeah, but they had no follow-up. BZZ went too early, and S4, no matter how long that silence duration is, they need all of those heroes there because BZZ doesn't do nearly enough damage on his own.
Yeah. I mean, maybe if BZZ was more from the scheme, it'd be a little different.
Well, shoulda, coulda, woulda for BZZ. G pops the BKB, Exorcism, Sleight of Fist, Searing Chains doesn't really do much as the BKB continues to go. Static Storm kind of wasted swap. Now the BKB is done. Hex is up, Force out. What a Sleight of Fist crit coming in. My god, S4. He might have just won the game there. Jesus. He's chasing after BZZ as well, who pops his BKBs. Please, sir, no, I don't want to get Searing Chains. It's too late. He's going to get right clicked down. Four dead. Virtus Pro. They've lost so many fights in a row that it just seems like at this point they're grasping at straws. And Secret now, with no Exorcism to worry about, no buyback for the Night Stalker.
Look at the damage done. Ember did 6,396 damage.
That Daedalus came at the right time.
He crit, I think, on two of those hits, and they were all cleaving, so that was pretty insane.
Jeez. Tier 2 tower, the last one. Nope, just kidding. There's a tier 2 tower bottom. But, well, the top racks at least is gone for Virtus Pro. And the Ancient Apparition Jotun is doing what he can, trying to push out bottom. He'll TP back home now. Tier 2 mid is going to take a spell. They're going to push in Effigies, Moonwells, other small hubs and buildings. And they're not long for this world. Any families living inside them need to vacate the homes immediately. Ice Blast sailing through into the mid lane. Yeesh! Now that actually didn't do that much damage at all. S4, Searing Chains, Yol's pushed back for the time being, and two Raxes for Secret. They can't get the third because of the tier 2 bottom, but they can go for the tier 4s if they so choose. However, heroes are coming back in. Yol's hexed up, stomp coming through, BKB for Kuroki. Wow, that damage onto Jotun. Jotun's double-edged, right click from Kuroki, force up, gets the kill. Yol, he's getting chased down, goodbye. S4, monster kill streak. Mid Rax finally finished off. Static Storm, BZZ, Sadoi just get blown up. Swap back out, Jotun just bought back, goodbye, dieback coming in. Ice Blast, Macro Power, Dual Breath does kill Puppy. He's the only one dead currently. Actually, Ember does fall, S4 went down. G's back in, Exorcism is up in 13 seconds, but No Tail silenced up. He can TP away, instead he chooses to man fight onto G. And they kill four, but the damage is already done. They actually team wipe Secret. But at what cost?
Yeah. Yeah, I think this one is in the books finally. There's not really much for VP to do at this point. They're not tanky enough to survive the Ember nukes, and they're just getting outscaled by the heroes from Secret. The Elder Titan plus Ember is just too much for them to handle at this point. They are getting a refresher on G. That's actually a big item pickup if you can get a double. If he can get a double full duration exorcism off, I mean, there is a chance you can win a team fight off of that, but I mean, they're all going to have buybacks, so.
The double BKB is going to be absolutely crucial. And yet, they will all have buybacks. Disruptor has it in 36 seconds. Misery will not have it for another 3.5 minutes plus 400 gold, so. There it is. If G dies, the game is more than likely over. And yep. The death push down mid comes from Virtus Pro. The only move that you can make when you're this far behind. They're going for it all. The Hail Mary. Aghanim Scepter for Virtus Pro. Puppy melts. He's going to have to walk out of the macro fire. Unfortunately, so slow that it doesn't matter. G pops the exorcism. Raxes might fall here. Okay, Virtus Pro. The beginnings of a comeback. Still down for 13 seconds is going to be S4. He doesn't seem to be too concerned. No buyback yet. He probably will just wait to respawn. One rack down. They're going to move to the top 2-3 tower. And now the real question is, can they take two Raxes? That'll be the issue. G has BKB.
Right, so Static Storm going.
Yule Scepter goes up. And BKB. G can't get it off. No Tail has an Aghanim Scepter. That's what's happening. Right. He's actually dead. And that probably just wins them the game. No Tail just kind of says quietly, hey, guys. Guys, I have an axe. Don't even worry about it. Misery chasing down Jada. There's the hex coming in from your offlane Elder Titan. Four down. Virtus Pro again. The death push mid. Well, it was exactly that. They died.
Yep. I didn't actually realize that he had an axe on that disruptor.
I don't think anybody did. At least not you or I.
And yep, that's going to be the end of game three in this series. So now Secret are going to have a 2-1 advantage. And might be looking to close out the series in the next game.
That could be an interesting one for Virtus Pro. We talked about the safe lane, or rather, aggressive tri lane, Night Stalker.
You know, it wasn't even so much that, because they actually ended up winning all three of the lanes. They just got a little bit impatient with their advantage. And they didn't wait for Exorcism cooldown enough, and they sort of, I mean, you could call it a throw. I know they felt under pressure because of the heroes that Secret have, especially the Elder Titan with Ember Spirit combination.
Regardless.
So they did feel that psychological pressure knowing that they got outscaled going towards that late game, but they just pushed a little too hard. I think had they played it, slowed the game down a little bit, just farm their own jungle, get the wards up, and then go 5-man instead of constantly getting picked off all over the map.